subscribe Tag TV YouTube channel and press the notification button.
People have to live in unity.
We are still in transition.
Civil society has been decimated.
Of course, we rely on media.
And I think the government has not done enough.
The international community has failed to respond.
No place in the world is perfect.
Yoga event is held here.
Severe injustice, and they should be stopped.
We should raise our voices.
Condemn this brutal act.
I'm your host Uzma Jafri with another episode of South Asia Focus. Let's begin the show with 12th BRICS Summit held virtually, where the member nations have shown their commitment towards global recovery after the pandemic. Prime Minister Narendra Modi exuded confidence in India's vaccine production and delivery capabilities in the fight against COVID-19 pandemic. Here's a report.
The leaders of Brazil, Russia, India, China and South Africa met for the first time since the outbreak of COVID-19 early this year. The BRICS, which is known as an influential bloc that represents over 3.6 billion people or half of the world's population, have joined hands to fight against COVID-19 pandemic and its economic impacts. In a virtual event hosted by Russian President Vladimir Putin, the BRICS member nations showed commitment to work together in these difficult times. Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi conveyed his country's confidence in vaccine production and delivery capabilities in the fight against COVID-19 pandemic.
भारत में हमने आत्मनिर्भर भारत अभियान के तहत एक व्यापक रिफॉर्म प्रोसेस शुरू किया है। यह कैंपेन इस विषय पर आधारित है कि एक सेल्फ रिलायंट और रेजिलिएंट भारत पोस्ट कोविड अर्थव्यवस्था के लिए फोर्स मल्टीप्लायर हो सकता है और ग्लोबल वैल्यू चेन्स में एक मजबूत योगदान दे सकता है। इसका उदाहरण हमने कोविड के दौरान भी देखा, जब भारतीय फार्मा उद्योग की क्षमता के कारण हम 150 से अधिक देशों को आवश्यक दवाइयां भेज पाए। जैसा मैंने पहले भी कहा है, हमारी वैक्सीन उत्पादन और डिलीवरी क्षमता भी इस तरह मानवता के हित में काम आएगी।
В нынешних условиях крайне востребована работа нового банка развития. На борьбу с пандемией банком зарезервировано 10 миллиардов долларов. В целом же портфель инвестиционных проектов к настоящему времени превышает 20 миллиардов долларов.
India hopes its 5 locally tested vaccines will help it to control COVID-19, as those developed by Pfizer and Moderna may not be available in big quantities soon. The 5 candidates include Russia's Sputnik V, whose phase 2 going to phase 3 trials in India will start soon in collaboration with Dr. Reddy's laboratories. The other experimental vaccines are the one being developed by AstraZeneca and Oxford University, which is being manufactured by the Serum Institute of India, Bharat Biotech and the Indian government's Covaxin. Zydus Cadila's Zycovid-D and the last one being developed by Biological E Limited alongside Baylor College of Medicine and Dynavax Technologies Corp.
ये बताते हुए प्रसन्नता है कि जो स्पुतनिक 5 रशियन वैक्सीन है, जो हमारा डॉक्टर रेड्डीज लेबोरेटरी के साथ कोलैबोरेशन में आगे बढ़ रहा है, उसकी भी ट्रायल की फेज 2 गोइंग टू फेज 3 इकट्ठा ट्रायल जो उसकी परमिशन उनको मिली है, उसका काम भी पूरी तैयारी हो गई है और जल्द ही जल्द सेक्रेटरी साहब बता रहे थे कि अगले हफ्ते तक वो भी ट्रायल इस धरती पर शुरू हो जाएगा।
The country of 1.35 billion people, India has reported 8.87 million infections, second only to the United States, and 130,519 deaths as a result of COVID-19. As the BRICS countries have agreed to cooperate with each other to develop a vaccine for COVID-19, a new hope emerges to effectively fight against the deadly virus.
Let's now move to Jammu and Kashmir, the Union Territory of India, where much emphasis is given to the promotion of sports. The region, which has produced many national and international sports persons, is now gearing up to provide a platform to the budding sports persons. The government is even more enthusiastic to organize local level competitions to keep them engaged.
This cricket tournament in the backdrop of beautiful mountains was aimed to hone the skills of budding cricketers in the Kashmir Valley. Held in Kupwara town of Jammu and Kashmir, the Unity Cricket Tournament organized by the Indian Army brought together several local teams from the Union Territory. The players are happy to get an opportunity to show their talent in the sports.
ऐसे ही टूर्नामेंट ऑर्गेनाइज होने चाहिए आर्मी के द्वारा ताकि जो हमारा टैलेंट है जो टैलेंट है यंग बच्चों में वो आगे आए
क्योंकि हमारा यूथ जो है जो छोटे छोटे बच्चे हैं टैलेंट आ रहा है जो टैलेंट है वो सामने आएगा और हमें भी मौका मिलेगा आगे जाने के लिए
Sports in Jammu and Kashmir got a facelift after it was given the status of Union Territory in August last year. The government has been organizing various outdoor and indoor sports events to provide a better career opportunities to the youth. Meet Afaq Rahim, a budding football player cum trainer from Gandharbal district of Central Kashmir. His aim is to become a professional football coach so that he can teach the youth in his area.
मैं मास्टर्स कंप्लीट करने के बाद मेरा जो अभी अपना प्लान है मैं एनआईएस के लिए जा रहा हूं तो इंशाल्लाह एनआईएस कंप्लीट करने के बाद मैं फुटबॉल में एनआईएस को जो डिग्री होती है वो मैं कर रहा हूं उसके बाद मैं लाइसेंस के लिए आऊंगा जो मैं कोचेस के लिए मतलब अपने आप को कोच बनाने के लिए तैयार कर रहा हूं क्योंकि जो डी लाइसेंस होती है बी लाइसेंस होती है ताकि मैं ये फुटबॉल में ही आगे इसलिए जाना चाहता हूं क्योंकि मुझे पता है गांदरबल कहां लैग कर रहा है जो मैंने अपने स्ट्रगल किया है मुझे पता था मैं कहां से लैग कर रहा हूं
The youth in Jammu and Kashmir fail to showcase their talent due to disturbances caused by cross-border terrorism and separatism movement, which is gradually fading away due to tough measures taken by the government. With the changing situation, not only boys, even girls are coming forward to take part in sports activities. At a recently held girls volleyball tournament in Baramulla, the young players were thrilled to participate.
हमने जीता हम बहुत खुश हैं हम चाहते हैं हमें और भी अपॉर्चुनिटी मिले ऐसे ऐसे मैच आए तो हम खेलेंगे ये हमारी बहुत ही हमारे लिए बहुत ही बड़ी अपॉर्चुनिटी थी जो हमें यहाँ पे खेलने का मौका मिला आज
Jammu and Kashmir is also a suitable place for adventure sports throughout the year. There are lakes, rivers and snow-clad mountains, which provide ample opportunities to organize adventure sports of national and international level.
Moving on. As Imran Khan's Pakistan Tehreek-e-Insaf emerges as the single largest party in legislative assembly elections held in illegally occupied Gilgit-Baltistan, the political parties as well as locals hit the streets alleging that the polls were rigged. They say that the entire political machinery, including Prime Minister Imran Khan himself, has been working overtime to bring his own party into power. We bring you a report.
As the results go in favor of Prime Minister Imran Khan-led Pakistan Tehreek-e-Insaf in occupied Gilgit-Baltistan, other political parties have hit the streets claiming the polls are rigged.
Gilgit-Baltistan ke awam ke vote pe daka dala hai.
Elections were held on 23 seats of the Legislative Assembly on November 15. PTI emerged as the leading party after it bagged 9 Legislative Assembly seats. The PPP came in second by securing 3 seats, while the PMLN secured 2 seats. 7 seats went to independent candidates who are expected to play an important role in the formation of the next GP government. Several political parties accused the PTI of rigging the elections and threatened to continue protests.
हम हुकूमत के वक्त का भी एहतराम करते हैं मगर जो जुल्म हमारे साथ करेगा उस जुल्म के मुकाबले में हम डट जाएंगे हम मर जाएंगे आज हमारे साथ प्री पोल रिगिंग के जरिए हमारे मैंडेट को चुराया गया है जिस अंदाज से चुराया गए हैं वो पूरा रियासती इदारों को भी पता है इंतजामिया को भी पता है हम आज इंतबाह करना चाहते हैं हम अगर हमें एक महीना भी यहाँ धरना देना हो और जब तक हमें इंसाफ नहीं मिलेगा हम रोजाना धरना देंगे
इन्होंने तमाम प्रेसाइडिंग ऑफिसर को बुला के रिजल्ट चेंज किया जिसके चेंज करने के बाद 2 वोट से हमें हरा रहे हैं इनको शर्म नहीं आती फिर भी पोस्टल बैलेट पेपर क्यों नहीं कोट कर रहे हैं ये इसलिए कि वहाँ उनकी पोस्टल बैलेट पेपर जितने कैंडिडेट हैं उन सब का हिसाब करो तो आज हमारी लीड है उसमें भी हमारे पास रिकॉर्ड मौजूद है जितना हमने पोस्टल बैलेट पेपर हमने जमा कराए हैं इनके पास हमारे पास रिकॉर्ड मौजूद है इनको खौफ ये है कि कहीं पोस्टल बैलेट पेपर हिसाब करे फिर भी ये ना जीत जाए इसलिए वो यहाँ से भाग गए हैं
Two former chief ministers, PMLS Hafiz Hafizur Rahman and PPA's Syed Mehdi Shah, have lost their battles.
गिलगित बल्तिस्तान के इलेक्शंस में धांधली हुई यानी 3 हलके ऐसे हैं जहां से बॉक्सेस जो थे पोलिंग बॉक्सेस वोट वाले वो ही चोरी कर लिए गए और बिलावल भुट्टो और मरियम नवाज जो हैं 2 बड़े लीडर पाकिस्तान के उन्होंने इन इंतखाबात के नतीजे को तस्लीम करने से यकसर इनकार कर दिया है और बिलावल भुट्टो ने तो यहाँ तक कहा है कि जब तक हमारी 3 जीती हुई सीटें जिनको इन्होंने धांधली से हरवाया है वो हमें वापस नहीं मिलती हम गिलगित बल्तिस्तान से नहीं जाएंगे तो ये है पाकिस्तान की एक गासिब हुकूमत की सरपरस्ती में होने वाले एक स्याह इंतखाबात
The elections were held amidst relentless protests by the people of Gilgit-Baltistan against the Pakistan government's illegal occupation in the region.
In Orthodox Afghan society, women were hardly allowed to engage in art and culture. After over 2 decades of end of Taliban rule, they still face challenges of free speech. Despite all hardships, the women in war-ravaged Afghanistan are trying to showcase their talent. Let's meet a young female artist who has opened an art gallery in Kabul. Have a look.
At a small gallery in Kabul, this lady carefully dips a brush in paint before applying it to a felt canvas propped up on an easel. Meet 27-year-old Faika Sultani, who had previously studied art at universities in Kabul and India and also worked in fashion. But she had been feeling depressed due to being out of work for nearly 2 months, a problem made worse by the coronavirus lockdown earlier this year, until she joined art enterprise Namad Company about a month ago. Painting profession has helped her make ends meet amid the pandemic.
ضربه که قرنطینه بر ما زد باعث شد که ما یکم افسردگی خاطر پیدا بکنه و جدا از اینکه بود اقتصادیش باشه ما بیشتر روح روان ما یکم خسته تر شده بود در خانه شیشه اما باز با آمدن در نمد و نقاشی کردن روی نمد باعث شد که ما یکم روح روان ما تازه تر شده و به زندگی نرمال ما یکم امیدوار شده
FICA hopes to motivate women of her generation to take bold paths and show the world another facade of Afghanistan, a brighter and peaceful nation. She has sold dozens of paintings so far, ranging between $100 and $200 each, and largely through word of mouth.
در کل وقت من نقاشی میکنم از بروز احساساتم روی کنواس یا روی کاغذ یا نمد فرق نمیکنه لذت میبرم و نقاشی روی نمد بر من این رو نشون میده که ما میتونیم سنت قدیم دوباره زنده بسازیم و بر مردم نشان بدیم که ما میتونیم از داشته های افغانی خودمون استفاده بکنیم و زندگی خودمون را رنگی تر و زیباتر بسازیم
Bogged down by the coronavirus, Sultani joined 21-year-old Marzia Panahi, who set up the Namad Gallery at the height of the pandemic in September.
مردم افغانستان با نماد یک ریشه تاریخی و فرهنگی داره که در طی خیلی سالیان گذشته قرنها مردم افغانستان در هر گوشه و کنار این کشور مصروف تولید نماد بودن. و امروزه تولید نمد کاهش پیدا کرده به خاطر از این که خریدار تولیدات داخلی کمتر هستن و ما خواستیم که روی نمد یک بحث جدیدی را مطرح بکنیم که اون نقاشی هست ما بتونیم نمد را از طریق دیگری وارد خانه‌های مردم کنیم اگر که اونا مایل نیستن که به عنوان فرش از نمد استفاده کنن پس میتونن به عنوان تابلو از نمد حمایت بکنن
Though the Taliban say they have changed, their public statements on women's rights have been vague, and many have raised concerns. However, the situation has improved significantly in the recent past due to the infusion of billions of dollars in international support and remittances from Afghan emigrants.
And finally, it's a festival season in South Asia and people are celebrating these events with all precautions due to ongoing COVID-19 pandemic. In India and neighboring Nepal, the Hindu community celebrated a series of festivals, Diwali, Bhai Dooj and Chhath Puja. Let's take a look at how the pandemic fails to dampen the spirit of these festivals.
Wearing colourful traditional outfits, people in India celebrated the festival of lights Diwali amid the coronavirus pandemic. People decorated their homes with lights, earthen lamps and offered prayers. Diwali is celebrated with great fervour in India and other parts of the world as it marks the return of Hindu Lord Ram to Ayodhya after 14 years of exile, defeating demon king Ravan, the powerful king of Lanka. It symbolizes the victory of righteousness over evil and the lifting of spiritual darkness. According to the Hindu mythology, it is also celebrated in honor of Lakshmi, the Hindu goddess of wealth and prosperity.
इस समय चूंकि वातावरण काफी खराब है, काफी लोग परेशान हैं इस चीज से, काफी hospitalized हैं, पर भी अपना त्योहार इतना पुराना है, पूरी निराशा नहीं रख सकते हम, तो बड़ी सादगी और सतर्कता से इसको मना रहे हैं हम लोग. दिवाली मेला वगैरह इस साल हम लोग कुछ नहीं कर रहे हैं बस रोशनी कर रहे हैं और लोगों को विशेष दे रहे हैं,
अपनी अपनी खुशी को प्रकट कर रहे हैं। जहां तक गो ग्रीन दिवाली है उसका भी ध्यान रखा जा रहा है, लेकिन कहीं ना कहीं मर्यादा पुरुषोत्तम भगवान श्री रामचंद्र जी महाराज का स्वागत हो रहा है।
In Nepal, the occasion is called Tihar, a five-day-long festival. Known as the Festival of Lights, Tihar is the second biggest festival in the Himalayan nation. During the festival, people decorate their homes with a variety of colorful lights and the sky is filled with spectacular fireworks at night. On the eve of Tihar, people honor crows, dogs, cows, as well as Lakshmi, the goddess of wealth and luck. Each day of Tihar festival has its own significance. The first day of Tihar is to worship crows, the messenger of death. People often sprinkle rice on the ground for crows pecking. The second day of Tihar is to honor dogs, the guardian for the god of death. The third day is welcome the goddess of Lakshmi. The fourth day is to thank cows. The fifth and the last day is Bhai Tika. On this day, sisters offer Tika to their brothers, wishing them happiness, long life and prosperity. Brothers, in return, pledge to protect their sisters from all kinds of adversities.
आफन्तजनहरू सबै रेस्पेक्टेड सबै व्यक्तित्वहरूसँग छौँ। समग्रमा आज चाहिँ हामीले दिदीको हातबाट टिका लगाई एउटा सुख स्वास्थ्य समृद्धि दीर्घायु उल्लासमय एउटा सुख शान्तिको कामना सहित शुभ होस् भन्दै दीपावलीको हार्दिक मङ्गलमय शुभकामना।
इन इन्डिया एन्ड नेपाल, the pious festival of Chhath Puja was also celebrated, where devotees took a holy dip and performed rituals. Chhath is considered as one of the most significant and auspicious festivals of the Indian states of Bihar, Jharkhand, Uttar Pradesh and neighboring Nepal. The pandemic failed to dampen the spirits of festivals, as it not only brings people closer but also create a good bond of humanity in the society.
The rich and vibrant festivals in South Asia are a testimony to our diverse tradition and culture. It even gives you the chance to celebrate the little and big things together. With that, we come to the end of this week's episode. See you next week. Goodbye and take care and stay healthy.